Royal babies don't eat like the rest of us. Here's what's on the menu. Very own is counting down the hours until baby Sussex makes its debut. Meghan Markle should be giving birth to her first bundle of joy any day now. Over the weekend, her mother, Doria Ragland, arrived in the UK to prep for the birth, and Prince Charles and his wife Camilla, Duchess of Cornwall, are planning on leaving the country on May 7th, which means the baby should be coming within the next week or so. We are sure that all of the staff at Frogmore Cottage are preparing for the arrival of the new royal baby. They are probably preparing the regular things like a room and nursery, but they are also most likely preparing the baby's meal plan. What do royal babies eat? There has been a long debate over whether royal mothers should breastfeed their babies. So, many women in the past chose to hire wet nurses. The French Enlightenment philosopher Jean-Jacques Rousseau objected to the prevalence of wet nursing in society. Carolyn Harris, Ph.D., historian and author of Raising Royalty, 1,000 Years of Royal Parenting, told Today. Royal and aristocratic women were not the only mothers who employed wet nurses at the time. The wives of urban merchants and artisans might have also sent their infants to be wet nursed by a peasant woman in the countryside so that they could return to work and the infant would spend their early months outside the city, where conditions were thought to be healthier. Why were royals discouraged from breastfeeding? Before Queen Elizabeth's reign, royal women were told not to breastfeed, according to Today. This was mostly due to the fact that breastfeeding has a contraceptive effect. In this time period, the main job of royal women was to birth as many royal babies as possible, so breastfeeding would have impaired their ability to do this. Some royal women like Queen Victoria found breastfeeding to be beneath them. How Queen Elizabeth changed history. When Prince Charles was born, Queen Elizabeth decided to breastfeed him, which opened the door for more royal women to do so. Following in Elizabeth's footsteps, Princess Diana breastfed Prince William and Prince Harry. William's wife, Kate Middleton, also breastfed her three children. What do royal toddlers eat? Once the babies are old enough to move to solid foods, their meals are carefully crafted. Prince William and Harry had their own menus created. Nanny was in charge of this menu and gave instructions on what Prince William could, would, and should eat. Chef Darren McGrady, who was the head chef at Buckingham Palace from 1982 through 1993, told Today. We started off with purees, vegetables, and fruits, and William even had his own nursery footman that would carry his, and his nanny's, food up to the nursery. Later, we would add in meat and puree it into the vegetables. During this time, there were two menus created in the palace, a main royal menu, and a royal nursery menu. Prince William's children also have a catered menu, both at home and at school. At Prince George's School, Thomas's Battersea, the meals are designed by a dietitian and feature items that you might find in an upscale restaurant, like lamb ragu with garlic, tomato and avocado bruschetta, baked smoked mackerel, and more. Will baby Sussex have a menu created? Markle has been known to be more health conscious with her food decisions and grew up in a holistic environment, so it is likely that she and Harry will have their own baby food made as well.